The following is a Leading the Way special presentation. Welcome to Leading the Way in Egypt, a Leading the Way evangelistic celebration. Dr. Michael Youssef has returned to the home of his birth to share a message with the thousands that have gathered in the heart of Cairo, Egypt. Joining Dr. Youssef is the Honorable Sonny Perdue, alongside special musical guests Mac Powell and Ziad Shihada. And now, let's join Dr. Youssef in Cairo, where the event is just underway.
مفيش حاجة في ودني بتتكلم.
أول ما يبدأ أنت تمام، إحنا لايف.
ماشي، بس مفيش كلام لسه.
مش هيبدأ لسه كلام.
ماشي.
I welcome everybody here in this place. There are thousands that are present here in this location in the midst of New Cairo. And I welcome millions of viewers on Leading the Way, King Saad, on the channels. And I want to welcome all those who are watching us. Please let's stand up and welcome them and give it up to them. Welcome in this great day. We're celebrating here being together. Together, we're celebrating the presence of God. We're celebrating a strong message that will touch every single heart present here in this place and watching us on screens. Once again, let us give it up to all those who are present here in this place. Welcome. Please be seated. I want to welcome a special welcoming to Dr. Michael Youssef and her and his dear wife in this historical visit to Egypt. Welcome Dr. Michael, and we thank the Lord for you and for your coming and for your heart that you give the message of the Lord to your people here in Egypt. I want to welcome a team of Leading the Way and all the staff who are present here today, not just for streaming but to prepare for this great celebration for a long days past and our long days are coming. Please let's give it up to them for this great team from the service of Leading the Way. I want to welcome once more singer Mac Powell, who is going to present for us very special songs in English language, and again expresses our unity of two people singing with English and Arabic. Let's give it up to him. He's going to be present with us in the program. And in the beginning of our celebration, I want to welcome in a very special way to a very important person with a high position, a man of politics, a man of education, Sonny Perdue. This person, for many years ago, he was the Minister of Agriculture at the American government. For 8 years, he was the governor of state of Georgia. Now he works as an important person in education for many universities in this place. He's one of the managers at Leading the Way. Let's welcome him and welcome his wife, Mrs. Ruth, and he's going to present to us a short word in the beginning and give us and tell us his testimony. It's a great day that a very important political man in this position who loves the Lord and want to give a testimony. Give his testimony. Please welcome him.
Well, good evening.
مساء الخير.
It is an honor to stand before you this evening in your beautiful country.
شرف كبير ان انا اكون واقف معاكم النهارده في بلدكم الجميله.
I have enjoyed a couple of days of seeing many of the antiquities here in Egypt that I've only read about in my life.
استمتعت الأيام اللي فاتت بأن أنا اتفرجت على أثار كتير قوي للمرة الأولى في حياتي بلدكم جميلة جدا.
But I stand before you here tonight as a very blessed man.
لكن أقف أمامكم النهاردة كرجل مبارك جدا.
I grew up the son of a farmer in the southeastern part of the United States.
أنا كبرت وتربيت في مزرعة في جنوب شرق الولايات المتحدة.
And I've been blessed with many titles since.
واتبركت بطرق كتير قوي في حاجات كتير في حياتي.
First of all, I am a husband, a father of four, and a grandfather of 14.
أول كل شيء أنا زوج وأنا أب لأربعة وجد لأربعتاشر حفيد.
I became a veterinarian.
وبعدين
a senator.
واشتغلت في حاجات مختلفة.
A captain in the United States Air Force.
واشتغلت في القوات الأمريكية.
A governor of the state of Georgia.
واشتغلت كمان محافظ أولي لفلوريدا.
Secretary of Agriculture for the United States.
واشتغلت كمان مستشار للشؤون الزراعية في الولايات المتحدة.
And now I am chancellor of the university system in Georgia.
ودلوقتي أنا بشتغل مستشار للنظام التعليمي الجامعي في جورجيا.
But ladies and gentlemen, I stand before you tonight saying my favorite title is a forgiven son of God.
لكن النهارده اقف امامكم يا احبائي وعايز اقول لكم انه افضل لقب بالنسبه لي هو ان انا ابن مخلص للرب.
Well, I have been married to my lovely wife Mary for 51 years.
أنا كنت متزوج من زوجتي المحبوبة لمدة 51 سنة.
I want to stand you and tell you that I would honestly give up all those other titles for the inner hope and peace that I have through my Jesus Christ, my Lord.
عاوز أقول لكم إنه ما فيش أي حاجة في العالم ممكن تخليني أضحي أو أترك السلام الداخلي العميق اللي حصلت عليه بسبب علاقتي مع الرب يسوع المسيح.
You see, growing up on a farm in the southeastern United States.
وأنا بكبر كطفل صغير في مزرعة في جنوب شرق الولايات المتحدة.
I learned to work hard and try to be a good son.
اتعلمت إن أنا لازم أشتغل باجتهاد وإن أنا أبقى ابن صالح.
Try as I might, I realized I could not be good on my own.
ولكن مرار كتيرة قوي اكتشفت ان انا مش هقدر اكون صالح وكويس بقوتي الذاتية.
Even as I tried and my mother thought I may be perfect, God knew that I was not.
ومع ان مامتي دايما كانت بتشجعني بتقول لي جرب وحاول هتبقى كامل ان شاء الله، لكن دايما كنت بوصل لقناعة من جوايا من ربنا ان انا مش هقدر اكون كامل.
God knew that I was a sinner, born a sinner, and I soon came to realize His truth that I was a sinner born in sin.
والحقيقة إن ربنا فضل دايما بيملأ قلبي بهذه القناعة والحقيقة إن أنا خاطي ولدت بالخطية ومحتاج له.
But fortunately, my mother took me to church, and I soon realized that I didn't have to be good on my own because Jesus Christ had been good for me.
وعند سن معينة ابتديت أروح الكنيسة وابتديت أدرك بشكل إن أنا مش محتاج إن أنا أكون كامل بنفسي لأنه يسوع هو اللي عمل المهمة دي نيابة عني.
Through His grace, I learned that His death on the cross paid for all my sins, the kind of sins I could never pay for myself.
من خلال موت يسوع المسيح ونعمته المعطاة لي عرفت إنه موته هو الوحيد اللي دفع ثمن كل خطاياي.
Knowing that I was separated from God eternally from Him, I realized that yet through His death, He paved the way for me to be reconciled to God eternally.
ولأني عرفت إن أنا منفصل عن الله بسبب الخطية ابتديت أتعلم وأفهم أيضا إنه يسوع هو اللي دفع الثمن علشان الخطية دي تمحى وعلشان يمهد الطريق لي عشان أكون في علاقة حقيقية مع الله هنا وإلى الأبد.
Ladies and gentlemen,
أحبائي,
I tell you there is nothing like the inner peace and joy an eternal hope that Jesus Christ brings in my life.
وعايز اقول لكم انه ما فيش اي حاجه احبائي تقدروا تختبروها مثل الفرح والامان والسلام الداخلي والرجاء الابدي اللي يسوع ممكن يديهولك لما يكون موجود في قلبك.
Well, I was a determined and focused and hardworking young man. He taught me love and joy and peace for all people.
وفي الوقت اللي انا كنت بحاول اشتغل بكل جد علشان ابارك الناس الله علمني ان انا محتاج اكون مليان بالحب طول الوقت لجميع الناس.
He taught me to love because he first loved me.
هو علمني هذا الحب لأنه أحبني أولا.
And it's God's love within me that allows me to love all people.
ومحبة الله بداخلي هي اللي بتنبع وتفيض جواي عشان تخليني أحب كل الناس.
In this world today we are confronted with turmoil, war, disease and famine.
في هذا العالم بنشوف طول الوقت حروب ومشاكل ومجاعات وأوبئة.
Yet through the cross of Jesus Christ, we can have eternal hope and peace that gives us the desire to live for Him.
لكن من خلال الدعوة وصوت يسوع المسيح اللي احنا بنسمعه هو بيدعونا ان احنا نستقبل فرح ونستقبل سلام أبدي من خلال سماع صوته والتجاوب معاه.
Jesus taught me that He died for all people.
يسوع علمني ان هو مات من أجل جميع الناس.
Here in Egypt, in the cradle of civilization, You played a part in the preservation of my faith by helping Jesus Christ and His legacy to live.
هنا في مصر في مهد الحضارة البلد بتاعتكم لعبت دور في إنها تحمي الرب يسوع في وجوده في أرض مصر.
I learned that Jesus Christ loves all people and wants all to come to Him. In all of eternity, there will be all nations and all tribes represented in heaven.
اللي انا اتعلمته ان رب يسوع يحب جميع الناس وهو يدعو جميع الناس من كل الشعوب والخلفيات علشان ياتوا اليه ويتجاوبوا معاه.
During my visit here in Egypt, I've enjoyed the antiquities that exist here in this cradle of civilization.
في وجودي في مصر اتفرجت على اثار كتير وانا موجود هنا بتعكس ان البلد دي فعلا كانت مهد الحضاره.
I noticed on the pyramids it had a label built for eternity.
ولاحظت عند الأهرامات إنه في علامة كده بتقول إنه ده مبني ليظل موجودا إلى الأبد.
Jesus said that all heaven and earth will pass away, but my word will never pass away.
لكن الحقيقة إنه يسوع المسيح قال السماء والأرض تزولان وكلامي لا يزول.
You see, having him in my heart, my soul is built for eternity.
روحي مبنية من جوايا علشان تعيش إلى الأبد.
And the hope that I have in Jesus Christ will allow me to live for eternity with Him in heaven.
والرجاء اللي عندي لأنه يسوع موجود وساكن في قلبي هو إن أنا كمان سأظل موجودا معه إلى الأبد.
So my prayer and my desire for you tonight is that each of you
صلاتي ورغبتي اللي يحصل معاك النهاردة
would know the inner peace and joy and hope that only Jesus Christ can give.
إن أنت كمان تختبر السلام الداخلي والفرح والرجاء اللي يسوع وحده ينفع يديهولك.
Through His sacrifice on the cross for you, for each of you, so enjoy that, welcome that, believe in Jesus, and He will give you the inner peace and joy in your heart.
يسوع المسيح مات من أجلك على الصليب عشان كده بدعوك إنك تستقبل دوت استمتع بيه تمسك بيه وهتقدر تختبر هذا الفرح والرجاء والسلام.
God bless you.
ربنا يبارككم.
خلينا اللحظات اللي جاية ده نشوف بعض اللقطات للمجهود الخرافي
of the great effort that's been done by the team to prepare for this meeting. Enjoy with me with these scenes before we start the praise time. We now have time to enjoy together and give the best song to the best person in the existence, our Savior, Jesus Christ. We're going to be led by Ziad Shahata. Please, let's give it up to him while welcoming him, while he's using his great talent that God's given him, that he leads the people of the Lord today to sing and praise the Lord. Ziad.
مجدا للرب.
Glory to the Lord.
أدوله مجد ليك بيه.
Glorify him. Give him glory that fits him. That great church of Egypt is welcoming you and glorifying that fits you and fits your name. You are the bride of her and the head of church. I'm really glad for this blessed time and that the Lord has blessed me to serve him together. A united church is given an atonement for her master. Let's honor him and being grateful for his presence. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For the Lord my dream. Hallelujah. For the Lord God Almighty reigns. Hallelujah. Holy, holy are you, Lord God Almighty. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb, for you are holy, holy. Are you, Lord God Almighty? Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Hallelujah. حبنا وقد غسلنا وجعلنا ملوكا وكهنا لله له المجد والسلطان إلى أبد الآبدين آمين 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 الذي أحبنا وقد غسلنا وجعلنا ملوكا وكهنا لله له المجد والسلطان السماء وعلى أرضنا مستحق يا يسوع كل المجد والسلطان السماء على أرضنا كرامة ومجد ليك كرامة ومجد كل المجد والسلطان في السماء على أرضنا مستحق يا يسوع كل المجد والسلطان في السماء على أرضنا ليس مثلك
ليس مثلك ألوف ألوف أمامك ربوات ربوات تخدمك ألوف ألوف أمامك ربوات ربوات تخدمك المجد اللي باسمه اللي في نظر أعدائه مغلوب قام الرب قام اللي في نظر
Solo
كل المجد.
All glory is His.
تقف معانا وتغني.
Please let's stand up together and sing and say, Great is God. My God is great. I have a great God. Sing with me. We have a great God. Glorify and magnify the Lord with me.
تسبيح السرافين لكن سمع مني الصلاة والترنيم من حوله أغاني
تسبيح السرافين
لكن سمع مني ومنك الصلاة والترنيم وبغني بين الناس أنا ليا إله عظيم بغني بين الناس أنا ليا إله عظيم نختم بترنيمة بتقول كل إناء مكسور متشقق
Every vessel is broken Your beauty of you Lord will appear through it Make the work of the grace manifest
كل إناء مكسور متشقق رب جمالك دي هيبان فاضي ولكن فيك بنصدق فيت مش بس يكون مليان شكرا ليك على تعبك فينا تشكيلك فخاري حكيم على صبرك على كل فشلنا وأناتك يا ابو قلبي رحيم اصغر عمل النعمة في أواني
Yeah.
شغلك فينا وأواني كرامة خلينا
كمل شغلك فينا وأواني كرامة خلينا
تسكينا هو
I think in a day like this, there are thousands from the people of the Lord are gathered together. I think it fits us that we pray for our nations, and it fits us that we speak about and pray for what's happening at our borders at Gaza. Please, let's take 2 minutes before we start hearing words from the tongues of the servants. Let's just lift up our hearts in this time and lift up the whole region with all the challenges we're facing in these days. Please close your eyes and lift up your heart. You've said, blessed be Egypt, my people. And you've blessed this nation. You've blessed this people. And you've blessed this nation. And we're coming today as Egyptians. And our beloveds who are here from out of our country, we're uniting together and we are telling you, Lord, look at this nation. Look at these people, Muslims and Christians. And have mercy on us, Lord. You've promised that at the times of distresses, you're going to be present in a way so supernatural. And you've promised that you're going to listen to the whining of poor people and the shouting of the church. And we're coming to shout before you, Lord, for the sake of Egypt, for this people, for this great people, for the sake of every financial need, for the sake of every hard challenges and circumstances, threats on our borders. Prince of Peace. King of Peace, Maker of Peace, give your command of peace, command peace, and send forth your hand in this war, in this very hard war, and look at the blood that's shed on the ground and cursing the ground, Lord. Look at the whining of children, poor, young and old, Lord. Look at the spirit of hatred and avenging. And come, you come and give your commands. Stop the shedding of the blood. Stop the shedding of the blood. You come, O Lord, in the hearts of the decision makers and command with peace. Order your peace and come and give and limit down the storm so it never goes out of this region and become a war in the Arab region. No, Lord. Never let this happen. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on the poor, the oppressed, and give the heart, every frozen heart, Lord. We pray for the frozen hearts. Give them the spirit of meekness. Give them the spirit of mercy and compassion. Give wisdom to the leaders and to the decision makers of our nation and the nations all around us. Lord, I'm praying for your servant, the president of our republic, heavenly wisdom to lead this ship in this very hard moments we're going through. We need to pray for you, and we're shouting for you. Hear and listen out to the prayer that your people is praying, and send forth your hand, and fulfill your will that's in your heart with all goodness for us and for all peoples all around us. In the name of Christ, we pray. All honor and glory are yours. Amen. Please be seated. We thank the Lord for a scene from heaven. We were enjoying singing. Really, whoever would come and stand on the stage would see something that would enjoy his heart and make us really feel happy that the Lord is present in our midst. Today, we are under the sponsorship of the presidency of the Evangelical Church. that we are all honored to be part of. So I want to welcome in a very precious person for us, and the Lord is using him in the life of the general church, and he's using him in a very important time in the history of church in Egypt. I want to welcome the Dr. Pastor Andrea Zaki, the president of the evangelical denomination in Egypt. Good evening. No, you're so down. Please. The scene here is really beautiful and awesome. I'm really glad and I welcome all of you. Welcome in this spiritual meeting, this special spiritual meeting. When I saw the title U-turn, I was really touched. And I kept thinking in my life, why should I do a U-turn? I'm going to say few thoughts in few minutes. U-turn is to turn back to my original identity, my original picture. At the prodigal son, the Bible says, and he came back to himself. The first step in U-turn, that you turn back to yourself. All of us were touched by the circumstances that is surrounding us. All of us are pressured and we are facing this ghost of great challenges. Turn back to your original identity. Stand for moments tonight. Where are you? Where are you standing? U-turn is a great step. The second thought, U-turn is a decision of freedom, a decision we take by our free will. Adam and Eve had thousands of choices at Eden. But the snake deceived them by half-truth, and half-truth is behind every single sin. And it told them, if you've eaten from this tree, you'd be like God, knowing good and evil. That's half of the truth. Really, when they're going to eat, they will know the good and the evil. But the second half, that they're going to die. So U-turn tonight is a decision, is a decision that you take by your free will, that you take it courageously to face this half of reality. U-turn is related with hope, and hope is one of its images, is the second chance. A second chance is important. People who have second chances, their lives transform. U-turn today is telling you that the Lord is giving you another chance, and another chance is a great thing. Really, the Lord hates sin, but he loves sinners. The Lord loves us, and because of this, he's given us another chance. U-turn tonight is a new opportunity for everyone who needs to encounter the Lord. It's a really important hope. Adam and Eve, when they committed sin, he made dresses for them. And he covered them. The Lord is covering us and he's putting his hand on us and telling us there's a new hope and a new chance. And it's related as well to keep going on our way and our journey. Many people keep just stand and stop their journey. A U-turn is a great journey with a new opportunity, with a fixed decision. I'm inviting you today while listening to the upcoming words. Let U-turn be a changing point in our lives. By the end of my word, I'm going to do things. First thing, I'm going to thank all people who are in charge. I want to tell you, there are like 11,000 individuals here and more than like 3,000 children. And for the first time, all the evangelical denominations are uniting together to prepare this. Let's give it up to all the evangelical denominations. The Council of Doctrine, the Evangelical Rabta, all doctrines and all denominations sat together to prepare tonight and for us to be here together. I want to thank the administrative team that was admining over all the teams and had a great role that we all be together here tonight. We had a group of teams. The first team is the team of preparation, a mobilization team, and this team helped in gathering all the pastors to share together. We're coming from 127 churches from Great Cairo. Thank you for this team. The second team, the team Come and See. I really want to thank this team that have distributed more than 10,000 cards for 127 churches. Thank you for this great and magnified effort. The team of prayer that has organized more than 16 meetings that were attended by thousands. Thank the Lord that there were people praying for this meeting, so we thank the Lord for them. The team of children ministry that has played a great role with children, and they're making a great program for 3,000 children here at the time we're gathered together here. Thank the Lord for them. The communication team that has done more than 110 cell groups and worked with a lot of people. All these teams were working together from different denominations, from large and small churches. They worked all together to do this great work. We thank the Lord for them, and we're shouting out for them. The last part of my words, that I present my friend and my master and my leader, Dr. Michael Youssef. A personal relationship connects me with him, but I'm going to speak about it at the end. Dr. Michael Youssef takes a pride, and we take a pride that he's from Egyptian origin. He has traveled to the West more than 55 years. He's the founder of Kingdom and Leading the Way, Kingdom Channel, and he's the senior pastor of the Apostles' Church at Georgia, Atlanta. He's authored a lot of books in the English language, and some of them were translated to Arabic, and Dar al-Thaqafa published it. He loves Egypt, he adores Egypt, and he loves the Egyptians, and he's really linked and connected, so deeply connected to his nation, and he shared in a lot of honoring participations to support Egypt. This man do a lot of roles and works on great levels to support our country. He really loves and adores Egypt. I welcome him. I welcome him. I welcome him. He didn't know me personally when I was a young man, but he supported me to study the master's and PhD, and he stood by my side. And I met him after 20 years after my studies. So he's a lover and a supporter to the church in Egypt. I wish that we welcome him a great welcoming.
ممكن نحيي هذا المرنم العالمي الشهير اللي جاي مع
singer that's coming with Dr. Michael Youssef Mac Paul.
انا هترجم له اول عباره وبعد
I'm going to translate the first statement he's going to say, and then I'm going to go.
Hello Cairo.
اهلا مصر. اهلا القاهره.
Hello Egypt.
اهلا مصر.
Hello to everyone joining us around the world online.
اهلا بكل واحد هنا وبالناس اللي بيتابعونا عبر العالم من خلال Leading the Way.
It is such an honor to be with you tonight.
شرف كبير إني أكون معكم النهاردة.
I've spent a few days in your beautiful country.
بقالي يومين ثلاثة في بلدكم الجميلة.
With wonderful people.
مع ناس رائعين.
And I am honored to be here with you.
وأنا لي الشرف إني أكون معكم هنا.
One quick question.
سؤال واحد سريع.
Does anyone speak English?
في أي حد هنا بيتكلم إنجليزي؟
Just a little bit.
Many people.
I'll sing in English.
Yeah. He will sing. هاي رنم بالإنجليزي.
Lord of all creation, the water, earth, and sky, the heavens are your tabernacle, and glory to the Lord on high. God of wonders beyond our galaxy, you are holy, holy, yeah. The universe declares your majesty. You are holy, holy, yeah. Lord of heaven and earth, Lord of heaven and earth. And early in the morning, well, I will celebrate the light. When I stumble in the darkness, well, I will call your name by night, yeah. God of wonders beyond our galaxy, you are holy, holy, yes. The universe declares your majesty. Hallelujah, hallelujah to the Lord of heaven and earth. Hallelujah to the Lord of heaven and earth. Hallelujah to the Lord of heaven, God of wonders beyond our galaxy. You are holy, holy. Declares your majesty, you are holy, 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 yeah, yeah. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great is our God. How great is our God? How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great is our God. Amen. So we are about to watch a video that I've been told is amazing.
هنشوف اللحظات اللي جاية فيديو.
I've heard this video is about a life changed.
قصة تغيير في حياة إنسانة.
A video about faith.
قصة إيمان.
Let's watch together.
اتفرجوا على الاختبار الرائع ده اللحظات اللي جاية. سيب ربنا يتلامس مع قلبك.
Since I was a child, I felt that I was worthless, that I was nothing. I have always felt like a failure and that I didn't matter. Since I was a child, I was unable to say no to anything and I made many bad decisions. I simply didn't know how to choose. Everything was the same in my life. I got married at an early age when I was about 16 years old. I was fascinated by the idea of getting married and I wanted to escape. However, I ended up separated from the world, and I felt even more alone. I also believed that I was very ugly. People would say that my face brought bad luck. I also believed I was the problem. I couldn't leave the house by myself because I didn't know how to protect myself. And I wouldn't be able to take responsibility for anything. Of course, I passed on all these impressions to my daughters. I always dressed them in a certain way. I always saw my daughters as not being special or beautiful. I myself didn't see them as I should have. I always felt that the solution to my problems was to leave Egypt. It just so happened that the revolution was taking place. At that time, people were offering to help me leave Egypt. This was not possible for me. I never went outside of my house. I would go out maybe once a year, and I rarely had visitors. But I don't know what happened. Suddenly, I found 4 passports in my home. For me, my husband, and my daughters, and with visas, we thought that we would travel, immigrate, and leave Egypt. And that is what happened. I sold everything I owned. I was leaving Egypt with a new hope to change my life. I thought, I am going to a country of freedom where I will feel valued and truly find myself. I stayed in Switzerland for about 14 months, and I didn't feel different. There were times when I would run away from home, go up to the mountains and walk for hours, and cry and say, Lord, find a solution for my life. I feel like I'm dying. At this time, I heard a sermon about the Samaritan woman, how Jesus accepted her even though she was going out and hiding from people. She used to hide from people because she felt ashamed and rejected. She was looking for love through illegal means. I saw how Jesus accepted her while she was rejecting herself. From that moment on, I began to believe that I am accepted in Christ. The Lord accepts me in spite of my appearance, my weaknesses, and my ugliness. Jesus is the one who can change me. At this moment, I began to see God's love embodied on earth through the Christians around me, in the way they accepted me and showed me unconditional love. My life with the Lord began from that moment. I started to move on. My life changed completely. I knew that my identity is in Christ. I returned to Egypt, where I didn't have a house or money. I didn't have anything at all. My daughters had to leave their university. But God was always there through the pain and challenges I was going through. He was shaping my life. I was not focusing on the rejection I was experiencing from those around me anymore, nor at the people accusing me for not succeeding in Switzerland. But I always tried to transform every pain and challenge I went through into being available to the Lord to make a difference in my life. At that time, the Lord was helping me, healing my soul spiritually. That was the journey I walked with the Lord in Egypt over the past 7 years.
Amen.
Amen.
I bring you greetings from Church of the Apostles in Atlanta, Georgia.
بحمل لكم تحية من كنيسة الرسل من أتلانتا، جورجيا.
Dr. Michael Youssef's church.
دي كنيسة دكتور مايكل يوسف.
My church.
ودي كنيستي أنا كمان.
I have the honor of joining together with many worship leaders there.
أنا لي الشرف إني أكون واحد من الناس اللي بيقودوا التسبيح والعبادة هناك.
I will now sing for you one of Dr. Youssef's favorite songs.
وحرنم لكم ترنيمة هي الترنيمة المفضلة لدكتور مايكل يوسف.
Thank you. The blind have sight, the deaf now hear, the lame will walk, the lost draw near, and with new life, the dead are raised, all through the power in Jesus' name. The tired find rest, the sick are healed. The mysteries of our God revealed. And now the truth can be proclaimed all through the power in Jesus' name. Name above all names, Savior and our Lord. Every knee will bow and every tongue confess. No other name is given by which we can be saved. Let us find our life and love in Jesus' name. The thirsty filled, the hungry fed, and those who mourn are comforted. The chains are broken that have enslaved. We're offered freedom in Jesus' name. Name above all names, Savior and our Lord. Every knee will bow and every tongue confess. No other name is given by which we can be saved. Let us find our life and love in Jesus' name. There is power, there is hope, there is love like you've never known. There is forgiveness and healing from your pain, all through the power in Jesus' name. Name above all names, Savior and our Lord. Every knee will bow and every tongue confess. No other name is given by which we can be saved. Let us find our life and love in Jesus' name. Let us find our life and love in Jesus' name. Thank you.
مساء الخير. Good evening. I always have to apologize.
دائما لازم اعتذر.
That I cannot preach in Arabic.
ان انا مش بقدر اوعظ بالعربي.
After 55 years of not using the language,
بعد 55 سنة وأنا مش بستخدم اللغة دي.
It doesn't come out right.
الموضوع يعني مش سهل قوي إن أنا أتكلم بيها.
In fact, my grandniece was telling me the other day.
الحقيقة حفيدتي كانت يعني تتكلم معايا من كم يوم.
She said, "Please do not speak in Arabic."
قالت لي يعني الله يخليك بلاش تتكلم عربي.
It sounds dreadful.
يعني الموضوع غريب شوية.
I am so honored to be here back in Cairo.
امتياز كبير ان انا موجود مره ثانيه هنا في القاهره.
And I am so indebted to Dr. Andrea Zaki for his invitation for me to come and all the pastors and the leaders of the church.
وانا مديون جدا لدعوه الدكتور اندريا زكي ليا ان انا اكون موجود معاكم وايضا لكل الرعاه والاسس اللي اشتغلوا في هذا المشروع.
You have honored me.
انتوا شرفتوني جدا بالدعوه دي.
Jesus said
يسوع قال,
that there is no prophet with honor in his own country.
إنه ما فيش نبي بيبقى مكرم في بلده.
But the church leaders here in Egypt changed that.
لكن قادة الكنيسة الموجودين هنا في مصر غيروا الفكرة دي.
Thank you.
شكرا
Thank you.
ليكم جميعا.
I am so indebted to Dr. Andrea Zaki's friendship with me.
أنا مديون جدا لصداقة الدكتور أندريا زكي معايا.
And I thank him for that wonderful introduction.
بشكره جدا من أجل المقدمة الرائعة.
I'm going to tell you something that is the absolute truth, and my wife knows this.
عاوز أقول لكم على حقيقة يا تقريبا مراتي الوحيدة اللي عارفاها.
I've been around the world about 76 times.
أنا سافرت في حتت كتير قوي في العالم تقريبا 76 بلد.
I've preached everywhere in the world.
ووعظت تقريبا في كل حتة في العالم.
But it's a very special privilege and honor to be in my home country.
لكن امتياز كبير جدا وشرف كبير ليا ان انا اكون موجود بوعظ في بلدي.
تحيا مصر.
تحيا مصر.
The Lord laid this message on my heart several months ago just for you.
الرب وضع هذه الرساله على قلبي علشان اشاركها معاكم انتوا تحديدا.
Increasingly, religious and non-religious publications are asking the same question.
بشكل متزايد كل المطبوعات والكتابات الدينية وغير الدينية بتسأل نفس السؤال.
Is this the end of the world?
هو دي نهاية العالم؟
Both the religious and the non-religious observers are looking at the current events and they're coming to the same conclusion.
المتدينين وغير المتدينين ايضا بيبصوا كده على الاحداث الجارية ووصلوا لنفس الاستنتاج.
One of the largest publications in the United States said the following.
واحدة من اكبر المطبوعات الموجودة في الولايات المتحدة قالت الكلمات التالية.
The end of the world is closer than we think.
نهاية العالم اصبحت اقرب مما تعتقد.
One of the largest publications in United Kingdom, the Daily Telegraph.
واحدة كمان من أكبر المطبوعات الموجودة في المملكة المتحدة قالت كده.
Ask the question.
سألت السؤال ده.
Is this the end of the world?
هل هذه نهاية العالم؟
So many global watchers are observing world events, and they're coming to the same conclusion.
ناس كتير جدا وهي عمالة تلاحظ الأحداث والحاجات اللي بتجرى في العالم وصلوا لنفس هذا التساؤل والاستنتاج.
But the most important question is this.
لكن أهم سؤال هو ده.
Are you ready for the end of the world?
هل أنت مستعد لو دي نهاية العالم؟
Jesus is coming back.
يسوع هيرجع مرة تانية.
And are you ready to meet him on the air?
هل انت مستعد ان انت تقابل يسوع مره ثانيه في النهايه?
Jesus told us that this world as we know it will come to an end.
يسوع قال لنا انه هذا العالم كما نعرفه سوف ينتهي في يوم ما.
Jesus, who holds the future of the world in his hands, gave us some things to look forward to.
يسوع الذي يمسك هذا العالم بين يديه اعطانا شيئا لنعيش من اجله.
He gave us some sign about the nearness of his return.
وهو كمان أعطانا بعض العلامات اللي بتشاور لنا على نهاية العالم.
In Matthew 24 and 25, he gives us some of these signs.
وفي إنجيل متى أصحاح 24 و25 يعطينا بعض هذه العلامات.
He said that these things are going to happen immediately prior to the return of the Son of Man.
بيقول إنه العلامات دي والحاجات دي هتحصل قبل عودة السيد المسيح إلى الأرض.
He said there will be wars and rumors of wars.
قال إنه هيكون في حروب وإشاعات أو أخبار حروب.
Another sign, he said there will be inflation and scarcity of food and even famine. Another sign he gives us is that the gospel of Jesus Christ will be preached to the ends of the world and then the end will come.
واحدة من العلامات الأخرى اللي أعطاها لنا إن إنجيل يسوع المسيح سيكرز به إلى أقصى الأرض ثم يأتي المنتهى.
And this is happening right now.
والحقيقة إنه ده اللي بيحصل دلوقتي.
The gospel is being preached in every corner of the globe.
الإنجيل بتاع يسوع المسيح بيكرز به إلى أقصى الأرض.
Jesus called these signs labor pains.
يسوع قال إنه العلامات دي عاملة زي أوجاع المخاض أو الولادة.
While we men don't understand labor pains,
احنا طبعا الرجاله مش بيفهموا قوي حكايه اوجاع المخاض دي.
But like Governor Perdue, we also have 14 grandchildren.
لكن زي ما كان الجوفرنر بيشارك المحافظ اللي احنا سمعنا مشاركته هو عنده احفاد كتير قوي.
We know when the baby is about to be born,
في ولاد او اطفال بيتولدوا.
The labor pain increases in frequency and in intensity.
السيدة بتشعر بألم هذا المخاض بشكل متزايد، فبتحس إن الولادة قربت.
One of these labor pains is the increase of selfishness.
واحدة من أوجاع المخاض دي هي تزايد روح الأنانية.
Another sign is falsehood and deception.
علامة تانية من العلامات تزايد الخداع.
Another sign, he said, is the increase in the number of earthquakes and floods and natural catastrophes.
علامة أخرى من العلامات اللي يسوع اتكلم عنها قال إنه هيبقى فيه زلازل وهيبقى فيه فيضانات وهيبقى فيه كوارث طبيعية.
And an increase in the loss of the value of money.
تزايد في تناقص قيمة المال.
Does this sound familiar here in Egypt?
هو بيدي هذه العلامات لنا جميعاً.
But then he gives us the greatest sign of all.
لكن بعد كده بيدي علامة تكاد تكون أعظم العلامات.
Here's what Jesus said.
ركز معايا هو ده اللي يسوع بيقوله.
As it was in the days of Noah.
وكما كانت أيام نوح.
So shall it be prior to the coming of the Son of Man.
كذلك يكون أيضا العلامات قبل مجيء ابن الإنسان.
For the days before the flood.
لأنه كما كانوا في الأيام التي قبل الطوفان.
People were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage.
يأكلون ويشربون ويتزوجون ويزوجون.
Up to the day Noah entered the ark.
إلى اليوم الذي دخل فيه نوح الفلك.
And they knew nothing about what is going to happen.
ولم يعلموا أي شيء عن إلا يحصل.
Until the flood came and swept them all away.
إلى أن جاء الطوفان وأخذ الجميع.
Jesus said.
يسوع بيقول
This is how it will be in the coming of the Son of Man.
بيقول ده شكل الدنيا قبل وقت مجيء ابن الإنسان.
This is one of the clearest signs that we are coming to the end of the world.
ودي واحدة من أوضح المرات اللي اتكلم فيها السيد عن نهاية العالم.
As it was in the days of Noah.
مثلما كان في أيام نوح.
So shall it be in the days prior to the coming of the Son of God.
كذلك سيكون أيضا في الأيام السابقة لمجيء ابن الإنسان.
Question.
سؤال.
What those days of Noah like?
يا ترى أيام نوح دي كان شكلها إيه يعني؟
God tells us in His Word.
الحقيقة في كلمة الله الله بيحكي لنا عن أيام نوح كان شكلها إيه؟
There were days of loss of morality.
كان في الأيام دي في فقدان للأخلاقيات.
There was an increase in hatred and lust and bloodshed.
كان في تزايد في الكراهية وفي الشهوة وفي سفك الدماء.
There is an increase in moral depravity.
كان في تزايد في الانهيار الأخلاقي.
We're now watching how in the Western world decadence and immorality is running supreme and impacting the whole world.
واللي احنا شايفينه دلوقتي في العالم كله ازاي انه في تدهور اخلاقي وفي مشاكل اخلاقيه مؤثره على كل العالم.
Everywhere in the world I notice there is a focus on the self.
في كل مكان موجود حوالينا وكانه احنا محاطين بالشر من كل مكان.
Let's look at the word of God in Genesis chapter 6 and see those days of Noah.
خلونا نبص على كلمة الله ماذا تقول في تكوين أصحاح 6 عن أيام نوح.
Chapter 6 verse 5.
أصحاح تكوين أصحاح 6 آية 5.
The Lord saw how great the wickedness of the human race has become.
ورأى الرب أن شر الإنسان قد كثر في الأرض.
That every inclination of thought and only evil all the time.
وأن كل تصور أفكار قلبه إنما هو شرير كل يوم.
My friends, please listen carefully.
أصدقائي عايزك تفكر بانتباه قوي في الكلام اللي بقوله.
We are watching the news from around the world of how wickedness and evil is prevailing.
احنا قادرين نشوف الاخبار من كل حته في العالم وبتورينا ازاي الشر والفساد اصبحوا منتشرين في كل حته.
We are seeing worldwide corruption and debauchery and greed.
شايفين قد ايه في فساد موجود في كل حته، قد ايه في انهيار اخلاقي في كل حته.
We are seeing how pornography has invaded every corner of the globe.
شايفين ازاي الفسق والاباحيه اصبحت منتشره في كل اركان العالم.
In the West, we have some rich and powerful people who are conspiring to destroy the innocence of the children.
وعندنا في الغرب عندنا بعض الأشخاص الأقوياء والنافذين والأثرياء اللي بيتأمروا لتدمير براءة الأطفال.
Jesus said.
يسوع قال كده.
As it was in the days of Noah.
كما كانت أيام نوح.
So shall it be before the return of the Son of Man.
كذلك يكون أيضا مجيء ابن الإنسان.
In 2 Peter chapter 3 verse 3.
في بطرس الثانية أصحاح 3 وآية 3.
He tells us about the last days.
بيحكي لنا الكتاب عن الأيام الأخيرة.
Scoffers will be saying, "Where is this day of the return of Christ?"
بيقول سيأتي في آخر الأيام مستهزئون قائلين أين هو موعد مجيئه؟
They have been saying this since for many years.
هم عمالين يقولوا إنه هيرجع بقالهم سنين طويلة.
Yet all these signs that the Lord Jesus Christ gave us are in place right now.
لكن الحقيقة إنه كل العلامات اللي الرب يسوع أعطاها لنا موجودة في الوقت الحالي.
As I view what's happening in the world.
وأنا ببص على الأحداث اللي بتحصل حول العالم.
I see some people in the grip of fear.
أنا شايف إنه ناس واقعة في قبضة الخوف.
Fear of scarcity of food.
خوف من نقص الطعام.
Fear of climate change.
خوف من تغير المناخ.
Fear of nuclear weapons.
خوف من الأسلحة النووية.
Fear of random asteroid collision.
خوف إنه يحصل اصطدام للأرض بكوكب ما.
But those who have placed their whole faith and trust in Jesus Christ as their only Savior and Lord need not fear.
لكن الناس اللي وضعت ثقتها وإيمانها بالكامل في يسوع المسيح من أجل خلاصهم لا يحتاجون إلى أن يخافوا.
In fact, we look forward to that day.
الحقيقة إحنا بنتطلع بشوق إلى هذا اليوم.
Because Jesus is our Savior.
لأنه يسوع هو مخلصنا.
Therefore, that day is a day of rejoicing.
وعشان كده هذا اليوم اللي هو يوم عودته سيكون يوم فرح.
The Bible said.
بيقول الكتاب المقدس.
Therefore, there is no condemnation upon those who are in Christ Jesus.
لأنه لا شيء من الدينونة على الذين هم في المسيح يسوع.
Please listen carefully.
من فضلك اسمعني كويس.
Did not say that those who are religious.
الكتاب مش بيقول الذين هم متدينون
or those who pretend to be religious
أو من يتظاهرون أنهم متدينون
or those who hope to be good enough for God
أو من يتمنون أن يكونوا جيدين بما no. فيه الكفاية لله
no
لا لا
those who have received Jesus Christ as their only Savior and Lord
من قبلوا الرب يسوع المسيح كمخلصهم الشخصي الوحيد
and when you place your whole trust in him
والنهاردة خليني أحط سؤال مقدس جدا قدامك.
You will have no fear.
ساعة لما تواجه هذا الأمر لن يكون لديك في
You will have no anxiety.
لن يكون لديك قلق.
You will have no worries.
لن يكون عندك قلق.
In fact, the opposite is true.
الحقيقة العكس بتاع كل ده.
You will have peace in the midst of the world's turmoil.
هيكون عندك سلام في وسط الضيقات والأحداث اللي حاصلة في العالم.
You will have joy in the midst of the world's sorrow.
هيكون عندك فرح في وسط الحزن اللي بيرمي عليك العالم.
As it was in the days of Noah.
كما كانت أيام نوح.
So shall it be in the days prior to the coming of the Son of Man.
هكذا سيكون في الأيام السابقة لمجيء ابن الإنسان.
Let's look closely at the days of Noah.
هو خد بالك خلونا نبص كده عن قرب لإيه اللي كان بيحصل أيام نوح.
First of all, those days were characterized by population growth.
أول حاجة هذه الأيام كانت بتتسم بتزايد أعداد السكان أو الناس.
Genesis 6:1 said.
الكتاب بيقول في تكوين 6:1.
Humanity began to increase in number.
ابتدأ الناس يكثرون في الأرض.
Of course, there's nothing wrong with an increase of the population.
طبعاً ما فيش أي حاجة غلط في تزايد عدد السكان أو الناس.
God blessed humanity and said, multiply and increase.
الله بارك البشر وقال أكثروا واملأوا الأرض.
So what's the problem?
فإيه المشكلة يعني؟
With the increase in population,
مع زيادة السكان,
it brings about an increase in moral decadence.
المشكلة إنه ده بيجيب معه تزايد في الانهيار الأخلاقي.
That is the problem.
وهي دي المشكلة.
For example,
مثلا,
in 1972,
سنة 1972,
there were 3.8 billion people in the world.
عدد سكان الناس كان 3.8 بليون.
In 2023, there are more than 8 billion people in the world.
في أكتر من 8 بليون شخص في العالم.
I know you hear the news. There are going to be food shortages around the world.
وأنا عارف إن أنتوا بتسمعوا الأخبار. الأخبار بتقول إنه هيكون في ندرة في الطعام في العالم.
During Corona or COVID-19 crisis in the United States.
في وقت الكورونا أو COVID-19 في الولايات المتحدة.
There were riots and looting of shops.
كان في أحداث شغب وناس دخلت تنهب في المحلات.
And the Book of Revelation tells us that.
والكتاب المقدس في سفر الرؤيا بيحكي لنا.
At the end of time, food will become scarce and expensive.
إنه في نهاية الأيام سيصبح الطعام نادرا وغالي الثمن.
Let me read to you what it says in Revelation 6:6.
خليني أقرأ لك الكتاب بيقول إيه في سفر الرؤيا أصحاح 6 وعدد 6.
I heard a voice say.
سمعت صوتا قائلا.
2 pounds of wheat for a day's wages.
ثمنية القمح يعني الكيلة بدينار.
6 pounds of barley for a day's wages.
وثلاث ثماني شعير بدينار.
And do not destroy the oil or the wine.
أما الزيت والخمر فلا تضرهما.
What does that mean?
ده معناه إيه يا ترى؟
According to the Global Network Against Food Crisis.
بناء على المعلومات اللي بتقولها حاجة اسمها الشبكة العالمية لمواجهة أزمة الغذاء.
Here's what they said exactly.
بيقولوا الكلمات دي بالضبط.
The food outlook.
المنظر العام
looks beyond grim.
بتاع توفرة الطعام يبدو قاتما للغاية.
As it was in the days of Noah.
مثلما كان في أيام.
So shall it be immediately before the return of Christ.
هكذا سيكون مباشرة في الأيام السابقة لمجيء ابن الإنسان.
Not only was an increase in population.
الحقيقة مش بس كان في تزايد في عدد السكان.
But there was unprecedented increase in knowledge.
لكن كان هناك تزايد غير مسبوق في المعرفة أيضاً.
In Genesis 4:17 it says.
في تكوين 4:17 بيقول كده.
Prior to the flood, there was an increase in knowledge.
إنه قبل الطوفان كان في تزايد في المعرفة.
They were building a civilization without God.
كانوا بيبنوا حضارة بدون الله.
Any civilization without the power of God will end up collapsing.
بناء الحضارة بدون معرفة الله سوف ينتهي بانهيار حتمي.
They had knowledge but they had no godliness.
كان عندهم معرفة ولكن ما كانش عندهم تقوى.
In fact, we're learning now that they had much greater knowledge back then than we realized.
والحقيقة إنه زمان هم كان عندهم معرفة ضخمة جدا أكتر مما ندرك.
The technology that built Noah's ark. It rival any ocean liner today.
الحقيقة إن التكنولوجيا اللي اتبنى بناء عليها فلك نوح كانت متقدمة جدا 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 في الزمن بتاعه.
It was a quite feat of engineering.
لأن هي كانت طفرة في علم الهندسة في هذا الزمن.
Today we have unprecedented increase in knowledge.
واليوم عندنا نفس الشيء عندنا تزايد هائل جدا وغير مسبوق في المعرفة.
Prior to the year 1900.
قبل سنة 1800
knowledge was doubling every 100 years.
كانت المعرفة بتتضاعف كل 100 سنة.
By World War II
بحلول الحرب العالمية الثانية
knowledge doubled every 25 years.
أصبحت المعرفة تتضاعف كل 25 سنة.
Today knowledge is doubling every 13 months.
اليوم تتضاعف المعرفة كل 13 شهر.
And with the coming artificial intelligence,
ومع بداية الذكاء الصناعي,
soon knowledge will double every 12 hours.
قريبا جدا هتبتدي المعرفة تتضاعف كل 12 ساعة.
As it was in the days of Noah.
مثلما كانت أيام نوح.
So shall it be in the days prior to the coming of the Son of Man.
كذلك سيكون في الأيام السابقة لمجيء ابن الإنسان.
Some of you might be asking.
بعض الناس يعني ممكن تسأل.
Michael, but there's really increase in knowledge. Too bad.
يعني يا مايكل ليه أنت حاسس إنه حكاية زيادة المعرفة دي فيها مشكلة؟
Isn't it a good thing?
يعني حاسين هي حاجة لطيفة يعني.
Of course it is good.
هي طبعاً حاجة كويسة.
So what's the problem?
إيه المشكلة؟
Knowledge without godliness and godly wisdom can be extremely dangerous.
المشكلة إنه المعرفة من غير التقوى يمكن أن تكون شيئاً بالغ الخطورة.
For example, now we know that knowledge that coronavirus was a result of knowledge went bad.
مثلا يعني احنا دلوقتي عارفين انه فيروس كورونا كان نتيجه لانه المعرفه دي تم استخدامها او اتجهت اتجاه خاطئ.
Scientists in China were experimenting to enhance genetics.
العلماء اللي موجودين في الصين كانوا بيعملوا تجارب من اجل عمل تطور في الجينات.
But they ended up killing millions and millions of people around the globe.
لكن انتهى الموضوع بهذه التجارب انها ادت الى قتل ملايين الناس.
Knowledge without godly wisdom.
المشكلة انه هذه هي المعرفة عندما تكون بدون حكمة إلهية.
Produces arrogance.
لأنها تنتج كبرياء.
And greed.
وطمع.
And selfishness.
وأنانية.
And pride and wickedness.
وكبرياء وشر.
And that's exactly the social and spiritual context of Noah's days.
وهذا هو بالتحديد كان السياق الروحي والسياق الاجتماعي في أيام نوح.
Listen to what the Bible said.
بص الكتاب المقدس بيقول إيه.
The Lord saw how great the wickedness of the human race had become.
ورأى الرب أن شر الإنسان قد كثر في الأرض.
That every indication of thoughts were evil.
وأن كل تصور أفكار قلبه إنما هو شرير.
So they were not only increasing the population.
فما كانش في بس تزايد في عدد البشر.
Not only is increase in knowledge.
ليس فقط تزايد في المعرفة.
But thirdly, there was a total disconnection with reality.
ولكن ثالثا كان هناك انفصال تام عن الواقع.
Jesus said in Matthew 24:38.
في إنجيل متى 24:38 يسوع قال كده.
As it was in the days of Noah.
كما كانت أيام نوح.
The days before the flood came and swept them away.
الأيام اللي كانت قبل الطوفان كانت بهذا الشكل بالضبط. مسحت كل حاجة.
They were eating and drinking and marrying and giving in marriage.
كانوا بيأكلوا ويشربوا ويتزوجوا ويزوجوا.
They were oblivious to the coming danger.
لكن حقيقة إنهم كانوا غافلين تماماً عن الخطر القادم.
Until the flood came and swept them away.
إلى أن جاء الطوفان ومسحهم كلهم من على وجه الأرض.
That's how going to be at the end times.
وهذا هو ما سيحدث في نهاية الزمان.
But there's something else that is so disturbing about the last days in which we live right now.
لكن هناك شيء آخر مزعج جداً بشأن الأيام الأخيرة التي نعيش فيها اليوم.
In the days of Noah, they just lost their physical lives.
في أيام نوح هم خسروا بس حياتهم البدنية أو الجسدية.
But in the coming judgment,
لكن في الدينونة الآتية,
there's going to be an eternity in suffering and torment.
سيكون هناك أبدية سيقضيها البعض في العذاب.
But again, somebody would say, "Well, but Michael."
لكن مرة تاني ممكن واحد يفكر ويقول لكن يا مايكل.
What's wrong with eating and drinking and marrying and giving in marriage?
إيه يعني المشكلة في إن إحنا نأكل ونشرب ونتجوز.
Nothing wrong with it. Nothing wrong with it.
لا ما فيش أي مشكلة في دوت مش ده قصدي.
But that's not the point Jesus is making here.
مش دي النقطة اللي يسوع عاوز يركز عليها هنا.
They were partying the night away.
الحقيقة إن هم كانوا بيحتفلوا طول الليل.
Like you do sometimes in the North Coast here.
زي ما في بعض الناس بتعمل هنا في الساحل الشمالي.
They were oblivious to the coming judgment.
هم غافلين تماماً عن حقيقة إنه في دينونة آتية.
They were divorced from reality.
هم منفصلين عن الواقع.
They were thinking that life is going to go on like this forever.
هم كانوا فكروا إنه الحياة هتفضل طول الوقت بهذا الشكل.
And that is why Jesus goes on to talk about the suddenness of his return.
وعلشان كده يسوع كان عايز يتكلم عن مباغتة أو مفاجأة هتحصل في وقت مجيئه.
Two people will be working together.
إنه هيبقى في اتنين بيشتغلوا مع بعض.
One is lifted up.
واحد هيأخذ.
And the other one has stayed behind.
واحد تاني هيبقى متروك.
And that is why it is very important that if you do not know Jesus as your only savior, you do that tonight.
وعلشان كده مهم جدا ان انت تركز وتختار تقبل يسوع كمخلصك الشخصي النهارده.
Food and drink now has become an obsession worldwide.
بقى في دلوقتي الاكل بقى منتشر عامل زي الهوس في كل حته.
Food and drink now has become the focus on our master instead of our servant.
أصبح دلوقتي هو الحاجة اللي بتشغل السادة وبتشغل الخدام.
Like the days of Noah, our priorities have turned upside down.
ومثل أيام نوح الأولويات أصبحت مقلوبة.
Whenever I go into a new country and a new city,
في كل وقت بروح في بلد جديدة أو مدينة جديدة.
I get to the hotel room.
بروح بالأوضة بتاعتي في الأوتيل.
I turn the television on.
وأشغل تلفزيون.
There's a cooking show.
بعدين الاقي برنامج طبخ.
Every country has more than one cooking show.
في كل البلاد عندهم برامج طبخ كتير قوي.
We're obsessed with food.
مشغولين جدا بحكايه الاكل.
I've seen it in Asia.
وشفت الحكايه دي
in
في اسيا
East.
وموجوده في الشرق الاوسط.
In Europe.
وفي اوروبا.
In the United States.
وفي امريكا.
They're obsessed with food. It's almost a pandemic.
بقى في هوس بالطعام عامل زي الوباء كده.
You know, in the health club that I go and exercise.
وفي المكان زي النادي صحي كده بروح اتمرن فيه ساعات.
And this is an aside now.
وركزوا يعني دي معايا ملحوظة دي.
Any of you who's over 75 like me.
أي حد فوق ال 75 زي كده.
You need to exercise.
أنت محتاج يعني تتمرن.
In order to serve God with all the energy He gives you.
علشان تقدر تخدم الله بكل القوة والصحة اللي هو عطيها.
But that's not the point.
لكن يعني مش ده اللي أنا عاوز أتكلم عنه النهاردة.
I'll be working on the treadmill and running.
أنا بروح كده بتمرن على المشاية دي.
And the person next to me on the treadmill watching a cooking show.
بعدين الشخص اللي جنبي على المشاية اللي جنبي بيتفرج على برنامج طبخ أو أكل.
Food that makes you fat.
أكل اللي بيخليك تتخن.
And it was the, as it was in the days of Noah.
مثلما كان الأمر في أيام نوح.
Where they were eating and drinking and marrying and giving in marriage.
بيأكلوا ويشربوا ويتزوجوا ويزوجوا.
So shall it be in the days prior to the coming of the Son of Man.
هكذا سيكون في الأيام السابقة لمجيء ابن الإنسان.
They were focusing on the wrong priority.
أنت عندك الأولويات الخاطئة.
Today there are people who enter and exit marriage for purely selfish reasons.
ناس كتير قوي اليومين دول مش بتركز غير في الحاجات دي زي الاكل والجواز.
The institution of marriage and the strength of the family are the cornerstone of a healthy society.
ولكن للاسف اصبحت مؤسسه الجواز اللي هي حجر الزاويه في مجتمعنا بتتعرض للهجوم.
But sin destroyed our attitude toward marriage.
لأنه الخطية دمرت اتجاهنا القلبي نحو الزواج.
Today people talk about any two people can get married.
دلوقتي ناس بتتكلم عن إنه أي اتنين ممكن يتجوزوا.
This perversion.
ده انحراف.
Is perverting God's blueprint for marriage and family.
لأنه هو بيدمر خطة الله وتصميمه الأصلي للزواج.
In the New Testament, the Apostle Peter tells us.
في العهد الجديد الرسول بطرس بيقول لنا كده.
In 2 Peter chapter 2 verse 5.
في بطرس الثانية الأصحاح الثاني وآية 5.
For God did not spare the ancient world.
بيقول إنه الله لم يشفق على العالم القديم.
When He brought the flood. Unto its ungodly people.
إذ جلب طوفانا على عالم الفجار.
But listen to this part.
عاوزك تركز وتسمع الجملة دي كويس قوي.
But he protected Noah.
لكن هو حفظ نوحا.
Why?
ليه؟
Because he was a preacher of righteousness.
لأن هو كان كارزا للبر.
The apostle Peter continues.
وده بيكمل الرسول بطرس هنا بيقول كده.
The Lord knows how to rescue the godly from trials.
يعلم الرب أن ينقذ الأتقياء من التجربة.
And God can deliver you tonight.
والله يقدر ينقذك ويخلصك الليلة.
If you come to Him and ask for His deliverance, He will deliver you, no matter where you are.
إذا أتيت له وطلبت أن يخلصك، سوف يخلصك بغض النظر عن مكانك.
When you hold, you place your whole trust in Jesus Christ.
أنت محتاج تحط ثقتك بالكامل في الرب يسوع.
He will set you free.
وهو هيحررك.
When you receive Him as Lord.
لما تستقبل يسوع كمخلص وسيد.
When you obey His word.
عندما تطيع كلمته.
When you love Him with all your heart.
عندما تحبه بكل قلبك.
He will protect you from danger.
هو سيحميك من الخطر.
That danger that is awaiting the whole world.
المخاطر اللي بتحيق بهذا العالم كله.
Even when people mocked Noah.
حتى حين كان الناس يستهزئون بنوح.
Noah's faith was unwavering.
إيمان نوح لم يهتز.
He stood strong.
هو فضل راسخ في إيمانه.
Inviting whomsoever to come.
بيدعو الناس اللي هتقبل دعوته إن هم يدخلوا الفلك.
Even when people could not see any sign of rain.
مع إنه الناس ما كانتش قادرة تشوف أي علامة على المطر.
Even when they ridiculed Noah.
حتى لما استهزأوا بنوح.
Noah placed his hope on God's word and God's promises.
وضع نوح رجاؤه في كلمة الله وفي وعود الله.
All the masses ignored Noah's warning.
الجموع اللي كانت بتسمعه تجاهلت التحذيرات بتاعته.
They refused to save themselves.
رفضوا أن يخلصوا أنفسهم.
And it cost them everything.
وقرروا إن هم يطنشوا الكلام بتاعه.
I pray tonight.
لكن بصلي النهارده
that no one at the sound of my voice anywhere in the world
انه ما فيش اي حد بيسمع هذه الرساله في اي مكان
would ignore the call of God on you to turn around and come to him
يتجاهل دعوه الله ليك اللي بتقول لك لف وارجع لي.
The Bible said
الكتاب المقدس بيقول كده
today if you hear his voice harden not your heart
اليوم ان سمعتم صوته لا تقسوا قلوبكم.
Please listen carefully.
ركز معايا كويس قوي.
God is calling you.
الله
He's calling you to escape from sin and guilt.
بيدعوك لأن تهرب من الخطية.
He wants to deliver you from addictions and depression.
يريد أن يخلصك من إدمانات بتقيدك.
God wants to set you free from fear and anxiety.
عاوز يحررك من الخوف ومن القلق.
God is calling you, and that's why you're here tonight.
الله بيدعوك وعشان كده انت موجود هنا الليلة.
He's calling you for peace and he's calling you for joy in this life.
هو بيدعوك النهارده للفرح وللسلام.
And they can only be found in Jesus alone.
ودي الحاجات اللي ما تقدرش تلاقيها غير في الرب يسوع وحده.
God wants to assure you that you can spend eternity with Jesus in heaven.
الله عاوز يأكد لك انك تقدر تقضي الأبدية بتاعتك مع يسوع في السماء.
Don't ever forget
لا تنسى ابدا
that heaven is Jesus's heaven
انه السماء هي يسوع
and no one can get to heaven without Jesus
ومحدش يقدر يدخل السماء بدون يسوع.
Jesus message in Matthew 24 is very clear.
يسوع في رسالته اللي ذكرها في متى 24 كان واضح جدا.
Do not make the mistake that the people of Noah have made.
لا ترتكبوا الخطأ اللي ارتكبوا الناس في ايام نوح.
Be wise today.
كن حكيم النهاردة.
Respond to the invitation.
تجاوب مع هذه الدعوة.
For Jesus said.
لأن يسوع قال.
What profit anyone?
ماذا ينتفع أي إنسان?
Of gaining the whole world and losing his own soul.
إن ربح العالم كله وخسر نفسه.
That's why I'm here tonight.
وعشان كده أنا موجود الليلة دي.
Proclaiming the gospel of Jesus Christ.
بعلن إنجيل يسوع المسيح.
Until God. As long as God gives me breath,
مادام الله لسه بيديني نفس,
I want to invite people to go to heaven with me.
عايز أدعو الناس إنها تروح السماء معايا.
I pray there'll be a million people in heaven because of the preaching of the gospel.
بصلي أن يكون هناك مليون حد من الناس جايين السماء بسبب الكرازة بالإنجيل.
Do not put it off.
ما تطنش الرسالة دي.
Don't postpone.
ما تأجلش.
I made a decision nearly 60 years ago.
أنا ابتديت الخدمة تقريبا من حوالي 60 سنة مضت.
I said I'll follow Jesus.
قلت أنا سأتبع يسوع.
And since that time,
ومنذ هذا الوقت,
I faced so many dark days.
أنا قابلت أيام كتير جدا مظلمة في حياتي.
It would take a book to tell you the experiences that I've been through.
ومش هقدر ما عنديش وقت ان انا احكي لك على كل الخبرات اللي مررت بيها.
I faced many tough times in strange lands.
قابلت اوقات صعبه جدا في اراضي غريبه.
But not once.
لكن ما فيش مره.
Did I regret my decision to follow Jesus.
ندمت على قراري ان اتبع يسوع.
He gave me peace in the midst of my troubles.
أعطاني سلام في وسط التحديات.
He gave me light in the middle of my darkness.
أعطاني نور في وسط ظلمتي.
He gave me joy in the midst of sorrow.
أعطاني فرح في وسط أحزاني.
He protected me in danger.
وهو حماني من المخاطر.
And he's blessing me so that I can proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ today.
وهو بيباركني لكي أتمكن من إعلان رسالة إنجيل يسوع المسيح.
Oh, how many times he encouraged me along life's highway.
مرات كتير قوي عديت فيها الحياة في حاجات مختلفة وصعبة.
Whether I found myself in the valleys.
لكن سواء كنت في الوادي.
Or on the mountaintops.
أو على قمم الجبال.
Jesus always guided my steps.
كان يسوع دائما يقود خطواتي.
And he wants to do that for you today.
وهو النهارده بيوعد انه يعمل نفس الحاجه معاك.
Jesus promised never to leave nor forsake his own.
هو وعد انه لن يترك ولا يهمل ولاده وبناته ابدا.
Someone here might say.
يمكن حد هنا سمعني كده بيقول.
When things really get bad, I'm going to get right with God.
يعني لما الامور في حياتي وظروفي بقى تبقى صعبه قوي انا هبتدي افكر في حكايه ربنا دي.
My friend, this could be your last chance to hear this invitation and respond to it.
صديقي عايز اقول لك انه قد تكون هذه فرصتك الاخيره لسماع رساله الانجيل فتجاوب معها.
You might never get another chance.
يمكن ما يبقاش عندك فرصة تاني تسمع فيها الرسالة.
Today is the day of salvation.
النهاردة يوم الخلاص.
Harden not your heart.
لا تقسي قلبك.
The notion that you are always can get right with God is a trap.
فكرة ان انت ممكن في اي وقت كده تصلح امورك مع ربنا دي مجرد فخ.
And it's a trap that's set up for you by Satan himself.
ده فخ الشيطان هو اللي حطه قدامك وعاوز يمسكك فيه.
Because he would rather you follow him all the way to the lake of fire which you prepared for him.
لأنه هو يتمنى ان انت تفضل ماشي وراه لغاية بحيرة النار المعدة ليه هو اساسا.
Satan wants to take as many people with him to the lake of fire.
الشيطان عاوز ياخد اكبر عدد ممكن من الناس معاه الى
بحيرة النار. By faith we're going to take more people to heaven with us than he does to hell.
لكن بالايمان وبالرساله اللي احنا بنكرز بيها هناخد ناس اكتر معانا الى السماء ليسوع.
I'm here to tell you tonight that you can be assured of heaven now.
والنهاردة أنا موجود علشان أقول لك إنك تقدر يبقى عندك يقين إنك رايح السماء دلوقتي.
Will you respond to his invitation?
لكن هل ستتجاوب مع هذه الدعوة؟
Will you come surrendering to him?
هل هتيجي وتسلم كل شيء لي؟
You will never be the same.
لما تعمل كده مش هتبقى زي ما كنت هتتغير.
Would you bow your heads with me in prayer, please?
خلونا نحني رؤوسنا في الصلاة.
I don't know where you are.
أنا مش عارف أنت فين.
But you know where you are.
لكن أنت عارف أنت فين.
You could be in a far country.
يمكن تكون في دولة بعيدة.
Or you could be so close but not close enough.
لكن ممكن تكون كمان قريب لكن مش قريب من المسيح بما فيه الكفاية.
No doubt you are hearing many voices right now.
ما فيش شك إن أنت دلوقتي بتسمع أصوات كتيرة في ذهنك.
The Holy Spirit is saying to you, respond tonight.
لكن الروح القدس بيهمس لقلبك ويقول لك تجاوب مع الرسالة اللي سمعتها الليلة.
But Satan is saying, not yet.
الشيطان بيقول لك لا مش لازم دلوقتي.
You got a lot of living to do.
أنت مازال قدامك حياة طويلة.
Who can guarantee the next minute?
لكن مين يقدر يضمن إنه يفضل عايش دقيقة تانية?
And so say to the Lord.
قول للرب دلوقتي.
Lord, I'm here today.
يا رب أنا هنا النهاردة.
To give you my life.
عشان أدي لك حياتي.
To receive you as my only Savior and Lord.
علشان أقبلك كرب ومخلص لحياتي.
To obey you for the rest of my life.
لأطيعك لباقي أيامي.
Let us stay in the spirit of prayers. My brother Samah Maurice comes up.
خلونا نكمل في روح الصلاة والأسيس سامح هيقودنا في صلاة في هذا الوقت.
This upcoming time is a very special time for every one of us. Please keep closing your eyes. You need to take a decision today that you accept the invitation of Christ for you or whether you reject it, whether you open your heart and accept Him as Lord and Savior or no. I want you in the spirit of prayer listen to this song by my brother Ziad. Your pierced hand, my Lord, you're calling me out. Your pierced hand showed me how much you've loved me. And you've sacrificed your life for my sake. Let's listen to our brother Ziad while he's singing this song for us. I don't want you to sing it with him. I want you to listen to it and look at crucified Jesus, this pierced hand and this hurt waist for you and for me.
يدك المثقوبة ربي تسبيني تشعل في أشواق وحنيني وتذكرني بأنك في يوم من أجل قسيت لكي لا تشقي يدك المثقوبة ربي تسبيني تشعل في أشواقي وحنيني وتذكرني بأنك في يوم من أجل قصيت لكي لا تشقيني خلاصي من الموت لسبب أنك ضحيت كيما تنجيني لم يثبك موت أو غلاء كنت مشغولا بأنين أنت معتقدي وديني أعشقك أنت ويديك
أنت
أشكرك أنت ويديك
في كفك ربي حبيني
في كفك ربي حبيني
Most precious thing in this celebration, Jesus is the one who's brought you here. And by his pierced hands, he's sending it forth. And he's telling you, give me your hand and touch the piercing. His pierced hand is sent forth for you. It wants to save you. It wants to take you out. It wants to save your life. And you can reject this hand today. But you can hold on to it and kiss it and tell him, I love you and I adore your hand. You have an opportunity today to respond to his calling and open up your heart and welcome him as your Lord and Savior. And you can go back home like you came, like you did nothing. Just wasted time. He's calling you out. He brought you here because he wants you and he loves you. And he's calling you for a relationship of love with him, to enjoy the best thing, not just the forgiveness of sin and eternal life, but to enjoy him himself. Jesus loves you. The upcoming song says, you're calling me out and I'm coming back. I'm coming to the compassionate Father. I'm coming with my tears, with my guilt. I want to go back home in your embrace. I want to go back home with you. I've lived so far away from you, but today I'm coming back to my Father. I'm coming to my original place, to myself. I'm coming back to my Savior. Let us all of us pray this song, whether you know him or not, living or with him or not. Let us all of us together say this first verse. And after the first verse, I'm going to tell you what we're going to do. Remember that his hands are stretched out for you. His pierced hand is calling you out. His stabbed waist is calling you out. He's hanged on the cross for your sake and for your sins, to give you life and to give you hope. Let us all together. I want to hear all your voices, please.
إن مريم كان
your eyes. Close your eyes with me. The second verse says, I'm coming with the sins of my years, my life that I spent away from you. And I'm coming back and telling you, please forgive me, O Father, and accept me. I want to be your son by truth. I'm here to give up my life for you. Close your eyes. Don't look at anybody. Forget about everything. You have 1 minute that is equivalent to all your life. Just close your eyes. There are so many people standing up. Please sit down. I'm gonna make you stand up again. Don't be afraid. Just sit down. If you're so far away from God, or was with him and got lost and the world has taken you away, if you don't have a living relationship with him and you don't have the peace that you heard of, if you don't have the joy you've heard of, if you don't have Christ in your heart, and today you want to accept Christ as your Savior and Lord, you want to repent today and come back to him and give him your life and live for Christ. I want you to stand up once more in the upcoming verse. But if you have a relationship with him, please don't stand up. And if you are rejecting Christ, please don't stand up. Please tell him, I don't want you. Keep telling him, I don't want you. I'm sitting down to say that I want you. But if you want him, because you're so far from him, and today you want to give up your life for him, please stand up and say with us the second verse of the song. I'm coming with the sins of my years, with my life that I've spent in wine. I'm seeing that most of the people are standing up. I don't think all of those people are so far away from God and want to encounter him. Maybe I'm not so clear in my invitation. If you're living with God and you have a relationship with him, please sit down. And if you don't want God, please sit down. If you have a relationship with God, please sit down. Yet you're standing up. This means that you want to give up your life for Christ. I have a great multitude before me standing up, and all of the overflows and people in front of screens. If you want to stand up, please do this. We need to pray together and spend the upcoming minutes together as an opportunity for you to open up your heart and give your life for Christ. Say with me the words and lyrics of this verse. Please, ushers, leave people alone. Today, please wait. We're gonna pray with people, and then you're gonna fill up the follow-up card. Pray it, please. Pray it.
عمري اللي ضيعته بعيد عنك.
My life that I've wasted away from you.
دقتي مرار البعد قاسي. وتمنيت ارجع ليك عدت لنفسي بدمعي بكيت عند البيت
صارخ
ليك بان عن الاب الحنان واثق ان انا ليا مكان
Please, once again, I want to repeat, if you're so far away from God and today you want to accept him, if you haven't given up your life for Christ and today you want to give it up for him, please keep standing. If you're living with him or you don't want him, please sit down. Please, while standing, pray with me. I'm going to pray a prayer that you can pray and open up your heart by it and give your life to Christ. Lord, I thank you that you brought me here today. I thank you that you've called me out today. I thank you that you love me even if I'm so far away and lost. Forgive me that I just was confused and did everything wrong and messed up. And forgive me that I've given you my back and walked in my own path. I'm coming with my guilt, coming with my tears, coming with my weakness. Forgive me, O Lord. Forgive me. Cleanse me by your blood. Open up my heart and enter, O Lord. Enter to the darkness inside of me and light it up. Enter to the sin inside of me and give me a straight life with you. Take the heart of rock and give me a heart of flesh, a heart that loves you and loves others. And live in your path. I've lived so for so long for my own sake, but today I'm making you and setting you as king of my life. Reign over me. Dominate over everything in me, on my thoughts, my eyes, my emotions, my heart, my money, my deeds, my decisions. I want to live with you. I want to live with you. I want the embrace of the Father. I want to call you Baba from now on. I want to be a true son, reborn from heaven, reborn from Jesus Christ. I thank you. Thank you that you listen out to my prayer. I thank you that you've accepted me. I thank you that I'm not going to go back home alone. I'm going to go back home with you. Your hand is in my hand. And you've said, whoever who are in my hand, no one can take them away from me. I thank you. I thank you. While standing, we're going to sing another song. And during this song, ushers are going to go for you, are going to reach out for you if you want people to follow you up and join discipleship groups and watch programs. Fill up this follow-up card. This card will help us to help you keep going on. If you're still lost and you don't know how to pray or you didn't pray and yet you want to repent, we're going to call you and help you to take serious steps in your life with Christ. Sing with my brother Ziad and keep standing to help us reach out for you and give you the card if you want to keep going with your life with Jesus.
صوته لسه بينده من سنين تعالوا إلي يا كل المتعبين صوته لسه بينده من سنين تعالوا إلي يا كل المتعبين
خليك واقف لغاية لما حد يقدر يوصل يصلي معاه
لو تعبت someone and reach out for you and pray with you
لأي جرح وأي داء وإن ضاع حلمك يوم واتاخد لاقي نجاة لو من نفسك روح قول له يا أبويا أنا عندي جروح استنى تبديني حياة هو مريح التعب
والناس الغلابة
بيحول الكآبة لأغاني وأفراح هو مريح التعب
بينادي عليك بينادي عليك
والناس is calling you out tonight
محتاج لأمان صوته لسه بينده من زمان محتاج سلام محتاج لأمان لو دايم مش لاقي طريق كل حياتك هم ودي وسط البحور الدنيا غريق دعاء وصلاه
Let us say this song again. It's a beautiful song. Oh, church, be happy because Christ is coming. We heard today that His coming is so near to take me to my home and my homeland, to the place where there is no tears or sorrows. Please let all of us stand up and say the lyrics of this song. Oh, church, be happy, for your bride is coming. Christ is coming to take us with Him. If you really give up your life to Christ, you have the right to enjoy and sing this song, because He's coming so near to take us to the home, to the true home, where there is no tears or pain or sorrows. There is eternal joy. We're going to see Him face to face, because we're going to be with Him. Oh, church, be happy.
Watching Leading the Way in Egypt, a Leading the Way evangelistic celebration from the heart of Cairo. Thank you for joining us today for this special presentation of Leading the Way with Dr. Michael Youssef.